Welcome to this overview of the on-demand capacity reservations, a new feature that Azure is introducing for virtual machines. My name is Bill DeForeest. I'm a principal program manager in the Azure Compute team. I'm excited to share with you all of these new developments that we're providing you as our customers. We're going to talk about what this feature is and what it does. We'll compare it to our existing capabilities for reserved VM instances, talk about some capabilities and benefits that this new feature will provide you, some common scenarios where you may want to apply it, and some billing and payment considerations before we move to a demonstration of the feature. So what is this new feature? An on-demand capacity reservation is a feature for virtual machines that allows you to get an SLA for a quantity of a particular VM size in a particular Azure location. It is something that you provision via the Azure portal or via the standard Azure APIs such as PowerShell, CLI, or your favorite SDK. Once you successfully deploy an on-demand capacity reservation, you will receive an SLA for that capacity to be available to you whenever you need to use it for whatever virtual machines of a matching size in the matching location you would like to deploy. So let's compare this capability to our existing reserved virtual machine instances, or RIs. Both the on-demand capacity reservations and RIs are applicable to virtual machines, and they typically apply to a particular size of virtual machine, or in the case of RIs, a family of virtual machines. The term commitment for the reserved instances of 1 or 3 years does not apply to the on-demand capacity reservations. There is no commitment required. You can create the on-demand capacity reservation whenever you want. You can cancel it anytime you want. You can keep it for 2 weeks for a special event, or you can keep it for 3 years for disaster recovery. It's really up to you. The on-demand capacity reservation's key capability is that it is a true reservation of capacity. It is set aside for you as a customer. It is backed by SLAs that Microsoft will make that capacity available to you, and we will prevent other customers from consuming the capacity that you've reserved. In contrast, reserved instances, the capacity is not technically reserved. It is prioritized, but it is not guaranteed. And so this is an opportunity now for you to get assurance that you will have the capacity you need to deploy your applications. On-demand capacity reservations is not a discounting mechanism. Typical usage rates will apply to your on-demand capacity reservation. If you want discounts, then you compare your on-demand capacity reservations with RIs and receive the best of both worlds. You get a term-based discount on your consumption, but you also get an SLA on the capacity that you need to run your business. Azure's goal is to support all of the VM series shown here. At this stage of our preview, we are supporting primarily our general purpose virtual machines. So our entry level AV2s, our burstable B series, the general purpose D series, compute intensive F series, and the memory optimized E series. The remaining series that you see listed here, including GPU, high performance, storage intensive, and the rest of the series that are grayed out, those we are working on providing support for all of those in the coming weeks and months, and we'll provide updates as we get closer to general availability. So the benefits of using this new feature include ensuring increased uptime for your applications. You can reserve capacity ahead of an actual deployment so that you know it will be successful and will not receive a capacity error. And you can scale your business critical applications with confidence. You gain additional operational agility. Azure is going to set aside compute capacity regardless of whether or not you have virtual machines deployed. And the capacity is reusable for any workload. If you want to deallocate your production workload overnight in order to deploy temporary workloads, run batch jobs, other kinds of things, other kinds of applications, that's all perfectly safe to do because Azure will keep that capacity available to you and will ensure that you can redeploy. You also get flexibility of deployment. There is no time commitment required. You can create and cancel on-demand capacity reservations at any time for any reason. You think of it like creating and deleting virtual machines. It works very similarly. Well, there's some common scenarios that we've heard from customers that in which they want to use this type of capability. The first is basic business continuity. So without on-demand capacity reservation, sometimes you need to do maintenance on your virtual machine. You deallocate it in order to replace it with a new updated image, perhaps it's Patch Tuesday, and you are going to go redeploy it at some point in the future, perhaps an hour or maybe even a day later. You'll notice in the top part of the picture that there's an empty rectangle, but in the bottom part there isn't. And that's because another customer has come along and taken the capacity that you had for your virtual machine while it was deallocated. This doesn't happen very often, but occasionally we will see customers who are unable to redeploy their virtual machine because in the meantime, Azure has had a surge in usage and we are actually running a little bit short on capacity temporarily. And in those cases, we do see occasional situations where customers will fail. With on-demand capacity reservation, you can remove all of these risks from your use of Azure. If you have the on-demand capacity reservation, then the reservation will remain in place even while your virtual machine is deallocated, So when you come back and reallocate your virtual machine, you can have full confidence that you will receive a successful allocation. The second scenario is scale out of mission-critical applications. So without an on-demand capacity reservation, if you're running your standard 2 virtual machines, you need to scale out to 4 due to either an immediate surge in demand or an anticipated one, say for a special event. In the current system, it doesn't happen again very often, but it does occasionally happen where if you try to scale out 2, 3, 4, typically it's a much higher number of scale out, you may eventually reach a point where Azure is unable to accommodate your scale out request. And so you could get, at the very high end of your scale out, potential VM failures. With on-demand capacity reservations, you can have the capacity set aside ahead of time, know that it's available to you whenever you need it. You can reuse it for whatever you want when you're not in your special event or when you're not requiring a full scale out of your application. And so when you go to actually scale out the application for the critical moments that you need it in order to support your business, you can deploy with full confidence that the capacity will be available. And finally, probably the most common request that we hear is customers gaining assurance for capacity in the event of a disaster recovery. So without a capacity reservation, today a customer will typically be deployed in their primary region, or in some cases their primary zone, and they'll have a secondary region and a secondary zone, or a secondary zone, that they want to deploy in the case of a natural disaster or something that takes part of Azure offline for a period of time. So today, when that happens, the primary region goes offline. There will be an attempt to fail over all the critical virtual machines into the secondary region or zone, and some of those may fail. This is definitely a potential with, say, a region-wide outage due to a natural disaster, because there are many customers who need to fail over to other regions. They're not all going to go to the same region, but if enough of them go to the region that you're targeting, there is some risk that Azure will run out of capacity before you fully failed over. With capacity reservations in place, you can have all of the reserved capacity set aside ahead of time and receive assurance that you'll get that capacity if and when a disaster recovery occurs. You can also have that capacity available when you need to run your disaster recovery tests to ensure that you have business continuity. So now, when the primary region goes down, the secondary region has the capacity set aside. If you have temporary workloads using that capacity, you would evict them as part of your client application, and then you'll be able to deploy all of your virtual machines into the secondary zone with confidence. So let's talk briefly about the billing and payment considerations. An on-demand capacity reservation is not about discounts. It is about the operational benefit of giving yourself an SLA to assure that you will have capacity in the event you need it for whatever reason. However, it is the case that if you have purchased RI term discounts, those will be applied automatically to your capacity reservation, whether it's being consumed by a virtual machine or whether it's sitting empty waiting for your future virtual machine. So this means that when you create an on-demand capacity reservation, you will be charged for usage as soon as you successfully deploy the on-demand capacity reservation, but you're only going to be charged once, either at the pay-go rates or at the reserved instance term discounts. The nice side effect of this design is that you can now decouple the payment process and the management of your term commitments, which is typically a financial operation for most of our customers, from the day-to-day administration of your applications and your use of Azure, where the technical people understand the capacity requirements and the performance requirements of individual applications. And so this allows the technical people to do their job and the financial people to do their job and not have to worry about trying to tangle the two together and make a decision about capacity versus term discounts. You just make each decision independently and the system just works. So with that, let's move to a demonstration. So let's see on-demand capacity reservations in action. In the portal, always start by creating a capacity reservation group. This will allow you to collect sets of different sizes of virtual machines, and potentially those machines across multiple availability zones, into a single object that you can then use for an application or as blocks of capacity for multiple applications. It's always up to you how you want to organize your resources. To create a group, the first step is to provide a name, and then the second step is to pick a location. If I pick a location, like US South Central, that has availability zones, I have the option of either leaving the availability zone set to none, meaning all of my virtual machines will be deployed directly to US South Central without specifying an availability zone. Or if I select one or all of the availability zones, then all of the virtual machines that I deploy will subsequently be required to specify the exact one of those availability zones that I included as part of the deployment specification. So just keep this in mind when you're creating your capacity reservation group. Do you want to use zones or do you not? For this example, just for simplicity, we'll pick a different region that doesn't have availability zones. This is where I'm going to specify the sizes that I want to reserve and the quantities that I want. You always give a reservation name, pick the quantity, and pick the exact size of virtual machine that you want to reserve. You'll be displayed a cost. This is the pay-as-you-go cost. If you have reserved VM instances available, they will be applied automatically without any intervention on your part, just like they would be for virtual machines. And as mentioned, you can collect multiple sizes under a single capacity reservation group. And this way, if I have a multi-tier application, I can have one group in which I manage all of my resources. Now, if I click on Create, I will attempt to deploy my reservation. My deployment has succeeded. So now we're going to go to view the resource. So here's my reservation group with the capacity reservation demo name that I gave it. And if I click on the reservations tab, you'll see that there is a reservation for the D2S V3 size and a reservation for the D4S V3 size, both of which I specified during my deployment. And neither of them has an allocated instance. So let's remedy that now. To use my reservation, I'd start by deploying a virtual machine just like I normally do. Pick the reservation group, give my virtual machine a name, no special requirements. I'm going to pick US West Central just because that's where my reservation is, and this is one of the sizes that I reserved. I can accept the defaults for the virtual machine, except for on the Advanced tab. This is where the new capacity reservation option will appear. If I drop this list down, here is the name of the capacity reservation group that I created and the specific reservation that matches the size that I'm trying to deploy. Azure will do the work for you. If you specify the capacity reservation group, we will figure out which of the member reservations are actually supposed to consume based on the size that you deploy and potentially the zone if you had specified zones as part of your reservation group creation. So if I go to create my virtual machine, I click create, and I will begin the deployment of my virtual machine. My virtual machine is successfully deployed, so let's go look at it. The virtual machine looks perfectly normal, has all the usual properties, but now there's this additional one, capacity reservation group. This is how you determine that this particular virtual machine is consuming reserved capacity. If I go back and refresh the capacity reservation group, now we see that there is one allocated instance of the and one instance that is reserved. So I'm using one instance of the quantity that I reserved, and I have one associated instance. For fun, let's go back and try this again. So I'm going to create another virtual machine. In the same resource group. Call it demo VM2. Notice that I'm specifying the same size, a virtual machine that I did last time. I'm going to skip to the Advanced tab, just like I did with demo VM1. If I drop down the list, the capacity reservation demo group that I created and the specific reservation of the D2S V3 size is available to me. So let's select them, review and create. And then deploy. The virtual machine is successfully deployed. If we look at it, it looks very much like demo VM1, and it even has the capacity reservation group associated with it. If I go back and look at my capacity reservation group, now we see that demo D2S V3 has two instances allocated against one instance that's been reserved. This is perfectly valid, and Azure will always let you do this if it has capacity available. It is referred to as overallocating, and so the overallocated column in this instance is set to yes. If you think about cases where you want to just deploy your virtual machines like you normally do and not worry about hitting the upper end of your capacity reservation, this is exactly why Azure operates this way. A capacity reservation is always the minimum number of virtual machines that you have reserved. You are always allowed, as long as space is available, to exceed that amount as part of your capacity reservation. Think about a virtual machine scale set that has an auto scale rule that might trigger in the middle of the night while no one's paying attention. We certainly don't want that allocation to fail just because you happen to hit the limit of your reserved space. So this means that Azure will always just manage and will always allow you to allocate as many virtual machines as we have space and you have quota available. Never stop you from deploying just because you happen to have used up your reserved capacity. It's also the case that if I go in and manage reservations, I decide that both of the machines that I have allocated are important to me and I would like to make sure that they're reserved. I can now change the quantity to 2. And now both instances of my D2S V3 VMs are occupying reserved capacity. Now, just for completeness, let's go back and look at the virtual machines that we have. And let's say I decide to stop one of my virtual machines because I don't need it right now, and I press stop. I say okay. Now my virtual machine is stopping. So my virtual machine is now in the stopped deallocated state, meaning is no longer occupying hardware in the West Central US region. However, the capacity reservation group remains specified on this virtual machine, meaning that if I attempt to deploy it again, it will automatically attempt to use the reserved capacity that I've set aside for myself. If we go back and look at what that state looks like in the capacity reservation itself, now, as you would expect, you have one of the two reserved instances actually allocated, but you still have both instances, demo VM1 that is now stopped and deallocated, and demo VM2 that is still allocated. They are both still associated with the reservation. This allows you to manage your usage of capacity and understand the expected use of capacity in the future. The difference between the allocated instances, one used of two, tells you you have one spot available for future use. The number of associated instances at two is one additional VM of expected demand in the future, and therefore you have enough capacity to cover all of your expected virtual machine deployments. In this way, Azure is giving you all of the tools for you to manage your capacity, both currently and into the future, as your use of Azure changes and grows.
If you want to learn more, there's documentation available. There's a web page for the reserved VM instances to review how that existing feature works. And we have pricing for Linux VMs and Windows virtual machines available for you to review. Thank you, and we look forward to sharing this feature with you as a general availability. And we look forward to hearing all the feedback on this great new capability.